So everyone, today in this video you are going to understand about estimation of alpha 1 by alpha rho metry. Okay, this is the scheme of the industrial biotechnology paper. Question number 1, estimate the amount of citric acid or lactic acid from the given sample A which carries 7 marks. Estimate the amount of alpha 1 in the sample given by specific rarity method. Okay, this is the question number 2 which carries 7 marks. Today, I am going to perform this, estimate the amount of alcohol in the given sample B, specific gravity method or alcoholometry method. Okay, now let us go through this specific gravity method. Okay, today's experiment is estimation of alcohol by alcoholometry. Okay, what is the name of the experiment? To estimate the percentage of alcohol by specific gravity method which carries 7 marks. Okay. In this 7 marks, experiment carries 3 marks, principle 2 marks, result and calculation 3 marks. Okay, so you need to focus on these particular distribution of the marks and you need to write the in the examination. Now let us go to the introduction part related to the alcoholometry of the alcohol. Alcohol is one of the products manufactured in large scale through the process of fermentation. It is a valuable solvent used in cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, etc. It is also as a disinfectant routinely in hospitals and laboratories. Then now let us go to the principle behind this experiment. Okay, the density of a substance is the ratio of mass and unit volume. It is expressed in gram per ml. Okay, the specific gravity is relative density of a substance to the mass of equal volume of standard substance at standard temperature and pressure. You must keep this particular in mind, this particular sentence you need to compulsory write and you need to highlight it. Okay? For solids and liquids, the standard substance considerable in a water and has a density of unity. The density of the liquid is determined directly by weighing a certain volume of liquid taken in a specific gravity bottle. Okay, the specific gravity of a liquid is determined by finding the ratio between weights of the liquid and that of distilled water at the same temperature in the specific gravity bottle. So this is about the principle behind the estimation of alcohol by alcoholometry. Okay, now let us go through the materials required for this experiment. Okay, materials required here, first one, specific gravity bottle. We need specific gravity bottle and we need weighing balance, alcohol, distilled water. So I have kept ready here specific gravity bottle. We need alcohol. Now alcohol sample is ready and we need acetone to dry the specific gravity bottle and you need blotting paper to wipe the outer wall of the specific gravity bottle. Okay, this is about the requirement. Now let us go through the procedure step by step. Okay, here first step, a specific gravity bottle is cleaned and dried. Okay, you need to take the specific gravity bottle, you need to clean this one thoroughly and you need to dry by using the air dryer, okay, or hand dryer. The empty bottle is weighed accurately with the stopper and recorded as W1. So this is your specific gravity bottle. You need to weigh this empty specific gravity bottle along with this stopper and take the weight. How much weight you are going to get, that you need to write as W1. Okay, you need to write that as W1. Okay, I'll repeat, the empty bottle is weighed accurately with the stopper and recorded as W1. W1 will be your empty specific gravity bottle. Then the bottle is then filled with alcohol such that it overflows and care is taken that no air bubbles are present in the bottle. Then the outer walls of the bottles are wiped until it is dry. Okay, then the bottle is weighed and recorded as W3. So W3 is nothing but your specific gravity bottle along with the alcohol. Alcohol means given sample. In the exam, what is the sample will be given? No, that sample you need to pour. So W1 already recorded. Now we'll be going for the W3. For this W3, you need to put the given alcohol sample. Okay, you need to put the given alcohol sample. Okay, so this is the alcohol sample. Now am going to pour this alcohol sample by using the petri plate. Okay, so you are going to pour this alcohol sample to this specific gravity bottle. You need to pour in such a way that that should overflow. Okay, this alcohol should overflow like that. You need to pour to the specific gravity bottle. Okay, and here you should not suppose to pour here only. By using the below, you need to use one petri plate. Okay, below use one petri plate. Keep your specific gravity bottle like this. Okay, then pour 70%. Water the alcohol sample is given by the examiner. Okay. And to fill the specific cavity bottle in such a way that that should overflow. Once it overflows, you need to put the stopper. Okay, like this you need to pour the given sample. Okay, maybe 7%, maybe 8%, maybe 9%, don't know, the exam how much are you going to get. Like that, then take blotting paper, wipe thoroughly the outer surface area of the gravity bottle and take the weight of this bottle along with alcohol. Okay, and this one will be your WO3, right? The bottle is then filled with alcohol such that it overflows. Care is taken, no air bubbles are present. It can't be overflowed, means there won't be any kind of air. The outer walls of the bottles are wiped until it is dry. The bottle is weighed and recorded as. Now you need to record this as WO3. You need to make a note here how much or whatever the number you are going to get. Then take out this one and decant this particular alcohol sample. Okay. Okay. Next, what is the next step here? The alcohol is drained out of the bottle. Then wash thoroughly with distilled water. You have to wash this bottle with the distilled water. After washing with the distilled water, then the bottle is filled with the distilled water and the outer walls of the bottle are wiped until it is dry and the bottle is weighed and recorded as WO3, distilled water bottle. So next, what you need to do, this specific gravity bottle you need to dry. Okay, if you don't have enough time for the dry, then what you can do here, you can put the acetone. Okay, you can put the acetone and you can dry your specific gravity bottle. Alcohol you have added already. Okay, but if in case if you want to dry this thoroughly, means you can add acetone and you can go for drying. Once they're dried properly, then wipe the outer surface area of the specific gravity bottle. Okay, once you dry properly. Next, what are you going to do here? Next, you are going to take distilled water. Okay, this same procedure you are going to follow here. Okay, you are going to place your gravity bottle onto the petri plate. Okay, then you are going to put the distilled water. Pour the distilled water in such a way that that should overflow. Once overflows, then put the stopper. Okay, like this. Then take the blotting paper and wipe thoroughly outer surface area of the specific gravity bottle properly and make sure that's dry. Okay, then take the weight of the specific gravity bottle and that will be your WO3. W2, W1 is empty specific gravity bottle, W3 is specific gravity bottle along with alcohol, and W2 will be specific gravity bottle with the distilled water. Okay, now the specific gravity of the alcohol is then calculated by using the formula. Formula is specific gravity of the alcohol is equal to W3 minus W1. W3 means that is nothing but the figure or number of the alcohol, right? So with the alcohol, what you have taken the number, no, that you are going to write here the weight. W3 minus W1 multiplied with density of water at the temperature. Okay, density of water at the temperature, then below W2 minus W1. Then the percentage of alcohol in the given sample is read against the corresponding value of specific gravity in the standard AOAC chart. So now we will have a W3 minus W1 and W2 minus W1 you have. Now let us understand about the density of water at that temperature. Okay, in this particular case, to check this density of the water at that temperature, first you need to check the density of water at that temperature. Okay, it means you need to check, usually you will get in the practical lab, you will get this kind of density of water table you are going to get. See, this is the temperature in degree Celsius, then density. Almost all the laboratory will be having this thermometer will be having. Through thermometer we can check what the temperature of that particular day. And for example, today it's 25 degree Celsius or 26 or 27 means. So today's temperature is 27. Then to this 27, you are going to get the density 0.9965. Okay, that 0.9965 you are going to put here. Okay, W3 minus W1, W2 minus W1, density of water at that temperature you are going to check through the density of water by going through the that day particular temperature and respective density you are going to write it here. Then you are going to calculate. Once you get the calculation here, that you are going to value the specific gravity in the standard OLCEA chart, you are going to check. Okay, so this is your specific gravity bottle. What I am using here, no, this is 25 ml measurement of specific gravity bottle. Once you get the certain number in the specific gravity of that particular value, when you calculate the specific gravity of that particular specific gravity, then sometimes you may get, for example, you may get 1.70. okay, you may get 1.70. if you get like that, what you need to do, this is your AOAC chart. In this AOAC chart, first you need to check the temperature. Okay, I told you that today's temperature is 27 or 26 like that. So here you need to check for the 26. In the 26 temperature, I got that value is 1.06. Okay, in this 26 temperature, I need to check for 1.66. I need to find out. Okay, here somewhere I am going to get 1.66, I am going to get it here. That number you are going to mention. It means what the percentage of alcohol was given was 1.66%, or in general you can mention that one as the 2%. Okay, so this is about the AOAC chart. Now observation and calculation part. Okay, so here weight of the anti-specific bottle, that is W1 here written, weight of the specific gravity bottle plus distilled water, that is W2, then you are going to write the grams. Then you are going to write weight of the specific bottle plus alcohol, that weight you need to write it as W3, right? Then you are going to do the calculation, that is specific gravity is equal to W3 minus W1 multiplied with density of water at the temperature, W2 minus W. So here this density of water at that temperature you are going to get through this particular density of water tabular column. Here temperature is there and here density is there. That day according to temperature you will get the density. That density you need to enter here and you need to multiply. And after doing this calculation, what is the number you will get, that number you are going to check in the AOAC chart. Okay, with the respective temperature you are going to check in the AOAC chart. Okay, then you will be able to do AOAC chart. Once you form the appropriate number percentage of the alcohol, you are going to write there percentage of alcohol is equal to this much you are going to mention. And result you need to write is very, very important. As I told, this carries or 2 mark. Okay. The percentage of alcohol in the given sample was found to be that much percentage, you need to mention. Okay. Hope you have understood today's concept. So estimation of alcohol by alcoholometry method. Okay. Thank you, everyone.